Hey, good morning everybody. Today is Friday, finally end of May. Don't forget to make the payment, guys. Appreciate your commitment to make the payment on time. So, appreciate for those that expiration the first day of the month. Okay? So, let's, review this market structure. I know that everybody's bullish, everybody keep buying. Call markets go up ad eternum, yes? The design has to go up ad eternum. Sometimes you have a pullback of 10%, 50%, 80%, but at the end, go up ad eternum, right? Anyway, so regarding today, I put all those notes in the market structure document. I ask you guys to review. Important are the levels, okay? Important are the levels when market you flip to the upside, when market you which level market you define that you keep going down. So important are the levels. The levels are pre-set up in the option book, right? So pay attention that the magneto, market closed at 5,235. The magneto, the minus GX is located at 5,255, and they are adding, positive gamma at 5,275. I want you guys pay attention that, dealers have been adding a lot of positive delta flow to not allow squeeze. So dealers is keeping the market in a negative gamma, but they are not generating, negative delta. So they are set up, support and resistance. Because what is the pattern of negative gamma? Sell dips by higher, right? By rallies. That's the difference in a positive gamma. They sell tops and buy dips, okay? So, but what they have been doing, because since, I started the group and we are not like in the same environment as, for example, as pre-COVID or as all the crashes, printed, right? I'm not telling that we will crash because this is a very controlled sell-off. Market is in distribution since, since COVID, since COVID. In some point, we will enter in a recession. When you enter a recession with money running without the cash, we tend to see some, turmoil in the market, the risky assets. I'm really, seeing all the people say, oh, you buy this, or you buy that, the results, blah, 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 blah. But I never see people talk about, the 10-year yield, bonds market, financial discount window, no. But is looking where the premium is located. Incredible. I never see people talk about, oh, I'm start to open a long position TLT. I'm start to open a long position GOVT. I haven't seen people talking about fixed income, right? Fixed income is paying 5%, 475%. The risk reward in fixed income is really high. The risk reward in equity is almost zero. Is almost zero. It's too risk because that I only do swing trades and cash out my money and put all the profits in fixed income, right? But anyway, I know that everybody's buying small caps. Everybody's is buying every single asset that even paid dividends. That's what I have been seeing everywhere, everywhere when people talk about financial markets, investments. Anyway, maybe the guy called Benjamin Graham is the dumbest person in the world. Nobody pay attention in the book called Smart Investor. Anyway, regarding today. So the magneto the magneto, the GX is 5,255. So we have the plus gamma. We tend to flip back to a positive gamma. Okay, 5,200 tend to hold any further cell pressure because, you know, the amount of negative delta. So the tendency, you know, the dealer sold those contracts. Okay, and keep market stable, volatility stable, and market trading in a range. So what you know, my points over here. So inflection point to the upside tend to be 5,275, 5,206 tend to be the rejection. So if you will break, expect the market, you know, back test 5,275. Okay, delta support, as I told you guys before, now is a resistance. So was 5,250, right? And now 5,250.55 is the plus GX, is the magneto. So the tendency now to bring market up, okay? Is the tendency to bring market up. This doesn't mean that, you know, markets you go to all-time highs, that market, you know, you break the pivot left last week, market you break the spinning top left in the last week candle. Doesn't mean that. The book still show weakness, not strength. We will flip to start to see strength, we're going to see, but not right now, right? So important is to check the level. So what, you know, I'm seeing is the market supposed to be trading in a range, okay, in a range, until, you know, all the premiums will be burned, will be collected by the dealers, and then they, you decide the movement, if they want to keep markets going down, or then you flip back to markets going back up, okay? But the tendency right now, what I'm seeing in the book, is market you be trade in a range to collect, you know, all the premiums. It's those people that play zero DT, be careful. You guys tend to be really fucked, right? They want to suppress volatility again, making market, you know, look the vega. So they tend to keep market trend in a range to suppress volatility until they decide what they will do. Okay, think about that. Wait the correct moment. Markets are eternal. Wait for the sign from the dealers to, you know, to open a position accordingly. But during the intraday, this is not a safe market. And, you know, the tendency to you guys to be fucked, okay? But anyway, pay attention in the levels. The option book levels are the most important thing. Today you have PCE, okay? For me, as I told you guys yesterday, for me the PCE tends to be calm, to come calm. I don't see PCE is coming like hot. As I have been telling you guys, why I'm bullishing bonds? Because the tendency of the yields is start to going down. The tendency of the economy is to enter in a recession. To yields explode higher and form a cup and handle, as I post you guys in the closed group, we need to see a war. If a war is going to happen, I don't know. Okay? I really don't know. What kind of the war? Russia wanna nuke Ukraine using nuclear bomb, or China wanna invade Taiwan and Japan try to defend Taiwan and get involved and things get escalated, Iran and Iraq get escalated as well. So this is the type of war that I'm talking about, okay? The only way to see the yield spike nowadays is to see a war, okay? Per history, you know, war tended to happen inflation tends to happen after war or in the beginning of the war. But the environment is to see the CPIs going down, okay? The environment is to see, you know, the inflation is coming down because economy is telling us that we went in a recession. Remember, they will cut rates. Yes, I think they will cut rates before end of the year. Yes, I think you'll be before end of the year, because the crash that everybody's looking for tended to happen next year, at least, you know, end of the second Q, in the second semester. in the beginning of the second half of the next year. That's what, you know, the paternity is telling us that's what will going to happen. As you know, the clock bond, the war clock bond that, you know, Trump implemented to Biden, Biden implemented a financial clock bond to Trump. This is how things work. Okay, this is how things work. And one will blame the other. Period. That's how things works. Okay? But I told you guys about the levels. Just pay attention to the levels. The magneto for today is 5,255. We could see markets, you know, it's going up at least like 20 points up. And you could see a rejection at 5,255. Remember that before, you guys have this everything in the market structure document. Before, 5,250 was a delta support. Now became resistance. Okay? Per GX. Breaking the 5,250, the rejection tend to be 5,206. And after 5,206, now the maximum upside target tend to be 5,275. Okay? So markets looks like is set up to trade between 5,200 and 5,275 until decide what the movement will be. Consequently, volatility will be suppressed and premium will be collected. Okay? This is the setup that, you know, is my interpretation accordingly, you know, the book that we have. Remember that over here, you know, look at the open interest that you have at 5,325 and 5,350 in the money contracts. It's really huge, the open interest. The volume was printed yesterday. So, they interpret, I don't know if they sold or I don't know if they bought, right? We never know if they sold, they want to try to bring the market at least above 5,235. Means that they will try to bring the market up to the magneto, okay? If they bought, expect in some point, you know, a revert, go to 35 and revert and go back and close below 5,220. Okay? You guys understand? If they sold this put spread, review the market structure document, expect a visit at the GX. Okay? Expect a visit at the GX at 5,255. That was the preview delta support. If they bought, expect a reject at 5,255. And expect markets going back and close below 5,225, okay? So those are the levels. You guys have all the levels. Don't try to guess. Oh, market, you go up. Oh, market's going down. So pay attention to the levels. Pay attention in the setup. You guys already have all the information. Dealers provide all the information to the option book. So it's very clear. It's very clear over here, put spread. So again, if they sold and try to collect the premium, they will bring market again to back test 5,255, where is located now the delta resistance, not the gamma resistance. That was the preview delta support. Look, Vega, pay attention that they will try to suppress volatility again. And they are more willing to collect premium than move the market. Remember that the market also is in acceleration mode since the GX dropped from 4 billion to 2 billion and liquidity have been added. You know, they are removing liquidity, so big players are not willing to buy so far. Okay, you guys have all the information, the book, the dark pool. Okay, you guys don't trade with buyers. Okay, you guys have all the levels and all the information. Okay, when you know markets start to break up, you know, couple levels, especially 5,275, we could start to have like a bullish bias. A soon market break down 5,200, yeah, you could be start to have like a more bearish bias. But so far, since the market is set up to collect premium, let's, you know, work with the levels, right? Let's work, you know, with the setup that dealers are well provided to us, all the information. Magneto, 5,255. First off level of rejection, 5,260. Maximum upside target tend to be 5,275. And 5,275 now is the inflection point to bring market again above 5,300. 5,275 is also the premium collection area. Guys, take care, enjoy your Friday.